Dan Close has struck gold. The project that he started working on as a graduate student at the University of Tennessee, Knoxville, has now turned into an award-winning startup. The product? Cell lines containing genes that glow. Naturally.
When we started, it was something that people said couldn't be done. We're working with making things produce light that don't normally produce light. It's had such a great mix of that sci-fi quality of creating glowing things and getting in there and modifying DNA.
The company, called 490 Biotech, formed by Close, Gary Saylor, Stacy Patterson, and Stephen Ripp, is founded on a specific biotechnology based on a phenomenon called bacterial bioluminescence. The researchers use a series of genes to trigger this phenomenon from human or animal cells to continuously produce light. The gene turns the cell into a tiny light bulb and allows researchers to see what is happening to the cell. A healthy cell continues to glow, a dying cell flickers, and a dead cell is snuffed out. The technology is especially important in drug trials.
For every pill you take that actually makes you better, there were thousands of pills that made people much worse. And the drug companies need a way to efficiently screen all of these different compounds. This type of system gives companies like pharmaceutical companies a very easy, very low-cost way to screen a large number of compounds very quickly.
Currently, drug companies are using a process where cells must be injected with a substrate to glow. Unlike 490 Biotech's system, this light only lasts minutes rather than days and dims over time rather than burning continuously. Also, only snapshot pictures are taken of the cell, whereas 490 Biotech's system provides real-time footage.
We've really reduced the amount of money, the amount of effort, and the amount of time that a pharmaceutical company has to spend screening their compounds while simultaneously increasing the amount of data that they can get from a single screen.
The researchers are working on producing 3 to 5 cell lines to go to market within the next year and a half. They can be bought by academic or private researchers or pharmaceutical companies and used for a wide range of research, such as cancer investigation or screenings for toxic chemicals in water, with one common theme: to make lives better.
What we've done can make a difference. What we've done can help people. And to do something that you care about that much and that you've had that much fun developing, and to think that what you're doing can actually have an effect in people's lives, has really been a very motivating and very rewarding experience for me and for everyone that's been involved in this project.